The concept of exploring the galaxy with self-replicating probes, most typically termed von Neumann probes after the eminent mathematician that first proposed the concept, constitutes what might be the most efficient way to at least explore a galaxy, if not maintain a permanent presence throughout it. At first glance, this concept seems reasonable. Build a probe that can mine materials and replicate itself and send it out into the galaxy to make copies of itself. In time, hypothetically speaking, you could have a probe in every system in a galaxy. The trouble is, the galaxy is well old enough for a civilization, or a number of civilizations, to have done this many times over. But we see no evidence that this has happened, which led to an argument originally by Frank Tipler that says since we do not openly see von Neumann probes within our solar system, then that would indicate the absence of other advanced civilizations existing within the Milky Way. Carl Sagan and William Newman took a somewhat different approach to the question and pointed out that self-replicating von Neumann probes wouldn't just be everywhere, they would be inherently dangerous. If left unchecked and replicating rapidly, they calculated that such probes, if they existed, would have consumed much of the Milky Way by now. Further, they hypothesized that no civilization in its right mind would ever design such a thing. It could be likened to the galactic equivalent of a doomsday device, and spacefaring civilizations might destroy such probes whenever they encountered them, or possibly even destroy any civilization attempting to create them. Robert Freitas countered these arguments by noting that those points were coming from extremes, and that in reality von Neumann probes might not be easily visible, and might not go rogue, and only replicate according to need rather than replication for replication's sake. In short, toned down functional machines rather than insane probes eating galaxies. But machines can malfunction, and if control of a probe's reproduction was lost, it could still reproduce without limit and eventually destroy a galaxy. So far, looking at the nearest galaxies that could have civilizations present within them, we've seen no such evidence that anyone has ever lost control of their self-replicating probes. There are no examples, so far as we can tell, of the galactic equivalent of a technological cancer. Perhaps this is again controlled. Maybe alien civilizations monitor each other's probes to ensure that the moment one malfunctions and goes rogue, it gets destroyed by the nearest probe that might be able to reproduce fast enough to outnumber it. But that creates more questions than it answers, and there could be technical issues within the whole idea once you put it into practice. For example, how do you power a self-replicating probe for long-distance travel? Is there a materials constraint, such as plutonium availability? These questions aside, say a civilization could safely produce a network of such probes and solves any potential replication issues with them. Could they be detected if they were out there? In our solar system, they might be literally a needle in a haystack. We don't know how big such a thing would be, but it need not necessarily be a Battlestar Galactica-sized ship. It could actually be quite small, and if its radio emissions weren't pointed at us, we might not see them at all. But aside from anything in our solar system, what of detecting probes in other nearby star systems? In a paper by Michael Gillon, a method for detecting alien von Neumann probes in other star systems is presented through searching for leakage from their communication signals in a very specific way. Straightforward interstellar communication is difficult and energy intensive. This would normally make it very difficult for a network of von Neumann probes to communicate with each other. But there's a trick. Stars are strong gravity sources, and gravity can bend and even focus light like a lens. Gravitational lenses can be used to concentrate signals, so von Neumann probes positioned to take advantage of this effect could communicate using far lower energies. So by looking across as much of the spectrum as possible at the solar focus points of nearby stars, you might pick up the communications leakage from a network of alien von Neumann probes. But this begs a question. If such a communications network is possible, and most suitable star systems contain a probe at this point, or multiple probes from different civilizations for that matter, would there be probes stationed at our own sun's focus point? We don't know, but if there are, they would be extremely difficult to detect. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently randomly releasing more short content, because that's what I do on this channel and always will. But for those of you that have been asking for additional long-form, regularly released content, you will soon get your wish, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.